दोस्तों, मंदामनी बीच ज़्यादा लोग नहीं हैं, कम है एंड बहुत ही एक क्लीन बीच। अगर आप आना चाहते हो तो मंदामनी बीच इज़ द प्लेस टू बी। एज यू कैन सी द वाटर इज़ नॉट दैट रफ एंड दिस इज़ द होल लुक ऑफ द बीच। देर आर सम उधर कुछ शैक्स है जहाँ पे आप बैठ के खाना खा सकते हो। दिस इज द मंदामनी बीच। सो अभी शाम के टाइम में हम लोग अभी वॉक पे निकले हैं इस रिसोर्ट के अंदर। यू कैन सी कितना बढ़िया स्विमिंग पूल एंड लाइटिंग सिस्टम यहाँ पे है एंड वॉकिंग के लिए भी काफ़ी अच्छा जगह है। वेदर भी बहुत ही अच्छा है तो ये वॉक के लिए परफेक्ट टाइम एंड परफेक्ट प्लेस। एंड आज लास्ट इवनिंग हम लोग का यहाँ पे मंदारमनी में एंड टुमारो वी आर गोइंग टू शूट ऑफ फॉर कोलकाता एंड आई विल सी यू गाइज ऑन द बाइक राइड टुमारो मॉर्निंग।
ओके गाइज, वी आर ऑन आवर वे बैक टू होम फ्रॉम Mandamani Resort and looking forward to the journey back home. But first things first, need to get fuel for my bike. The best part and the worst part, sorry, the best part of the journey is the worst. We're going to cover the worst kind of roads right at the beginning, which was not the case while coming down here. So as we are fresh, the next 24 kilometers is going to be critical. Get past this first hurdle, getting past this first hurdle is the first challenge. Not challenge, challenge for me maybe because I'm riding for the first time. Not challenge for my friend who is a pretty seasoned rider. ये एक छोटा सा ऑफ रोडिंग टाइप का एक्सपीरियंस हो रहा है। द रास्ता इज नॉट वेरी गुड बट मीटियर का स्टेबिलिटी इज वेरी वेरी गुड। एनीबडी हैज नॉट बीन इन अ लॉन्ग राइड ऑन द मीटियर विल फाइंड दिस बाइक वर्थ एवरी पेनी एंड वर्थ ऑल ऑफ योर इमोशंस। It's a big bike, it's a super stable and smooth bike. So, as I was saying, काफी अच्छा बाइक है एंड अभी तक तो कमिंग अप सॉरी बाप रे ऑन द वे जब हम लोग आए थे यहाँ पे जर्नी में इट वॉज वेरी स्मूथ। मैं चला रहा था एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ 70 टू 80 के बीच में फॉर द फर्स्ट 100 किलोमीटर। द नेक्स्ट 90 और किलोमीटर द स्पीड वॉज अराउंड 55 टू 65 ड्यू टू कंजेशन एंड ड्यू टू टू लेन हाईवेज एंड हैव टू बी केयरफुल। जो मजेदार चीज हुआ, मजेदार लेकिन कैमरे पे नहीं आया, वो तब कैमरा ऑफ था, कि जब मैं चला रहा था हाईवे पे आने का वक्त कौन हॉर्न मार रहा है भाई इधर, और सामने का बाइक हॉर्न मार रहा है। जब मैं चला रहा था आई वाज एट 90 एट वन पॉइंट, तब सडनली यू एक्सपेक्ट मेरी काउज डॉग्स but you don't expect actually you don't expect anybody, you just run across the road and what I see is ek bada bandar langur ke bolta hai jumping across the highway right in front of my bike. Maybe he was around 15 feet away. Ye 15 feet ki duri mein mujhe to almost heart attack hi aa gaya. पहली राइड में एक ऐसा नजारा, तो हाईवे में कुछ भी हो सकता है। यूजर्स हैव टू बी केयरफुल। अभी तो हम इमीडिएट डेस्टिनेशन इज द नेक्स्ट पेट्रोल पंप बिकॉज वी नीड टू डेस्परेटली गेट फ्यूल।
ओके
सो हियर वी गो आफ्टर सम ब्रेक एंड रिप्लेनिशिंग आवर सॉल्ट्स वी आर ऑन द वे बैक टू कोलकाता। Stopping for brakes is actually more tiresome. Feels, you know, you got to take care of the gear, your bags. Oh, bloody hell! The bumps are not funny here. As long as you're riding, you're good. But then you need to take a break. I mean, if you take a break, there's another lengthy procedure to open your helmet, open your gears. If you're having something, so we are on the way back, and these roads are not really the easiest to drive. As you can see, the corners are sharp and these big trucks and buses, one has to be a little careful. These corners are really not funny, and these have different levels. The roads are of different level from the soil, so if your tire is unfortunately on one of them, you will skid and you will get onto the path. There's a lot of protection due to the election coming up. There's a lot of CRPF and army protection and vigilance happening throughout the state of Bengal. I've seen quite a few riders today. As per meteor riders, I've seen 3 meteors in the entire trip so far. Coming right now, I saw one a while back, and while coming to Mandamani, I saw a couple of fireballs. I have seen fireball only, the fireball variant, not the supernova, not the stellar ones. My friends, where are they? For a change, I am ahead because it started ahead. So, I also saw a few. I saw the Hooks one. It looks really odd, the bike, but I really want to ride it and do a vlog on that, maybe a test ride. Yeah, it's not funny when, you know, car or buses sneak up to you and blow their horn at full flow. It's kind of scary, and it also distracts you as a rider. Another problem I faced with the meteor is the rear view mirrors are not the best of its class. This circular shape is not giving me the entire view that I would like to have. I had an Avenger before this, and the rear view mirror on that one was fantastic. So I'm thinking, maybe for the next trip, I will install mirrors from the Avenger. So that's one thing, and also because of the wind blast, the right mirror came loose quite a few times on when I was coming. Not now, when I tightened it a little bit, but I have to get it checked by a mechanic. And as for wind, I haven't been troubled by the wind really. Kolkata is 126 kilometers from here, Kolakata is another 61 kilometers. I think we are doing pretty good, well on time. The force of the wind from the sides is not funny. It's really pretty, you know, it really shakes you up, the force on the wind from the side. But coming back to Meteor, what a fantastic bike, absolutely stunning bike. The stability and the smoothness on this bike, even at 80, 90, is very, very good, very strong. Though I would love to have more power at the top end, but even with 5 gears, whatever it's giving, it's good. It's definitely good, and it's definitely, as I said before, worth every penny. If you're thinking of buying the Royal Enfield Meteor, it'll give you a lot of pleasure. You feel that there is a thump. You know, people say the Meteor doesn't have a thump. That's wrong, that's rubbish. There is a thump, but this thump is different. It is not your raspy, usually raspy thump like the Classic has, which is also very nice. This thump is a growl. It's a growl. Okay, it's a very aesthetic sounding, soothing to the ears thump. And I love it. And I don't want to change the exhaust. A lot of people want to change the exhaust to, for whatever reasons, to hear a better thump, or this thump is not enough for them. But really, even when I'm wearing the helmet, I can hear the thump. It is delicious. I love that bassy sound of a bike. I am not a fan of the throaty, raspy sound. I'm more of a bass person, and I like that heaviness that this bike provides in the thump. And this thump has a personality of its own. So, lovely motorcycle, and really the clusters, I like the clusters, it's so nice, it's clear, easy to see. So we are on our way. After resolving the meter console issue I had, the issue, I really don't know what the issue was in particular, but I put the bike on side stand and switched on and off the bike, and the speedometer behaved normally. It made a full swipe of the cluster, and seems to be solid for now, but I'll still get it checked by a mechanic, and once I get home, and maybe in a day or two, I'll get it checked and sorted out, the meter console. So I like my bike to be in top shape, even when I'm not riding. And right now we are on our way towards Kolakata. We are not going to stop there. It's just a destination for us to cross on our way to Calcutta. Nandakumar was when we crossed Nandakumar, it took us good 10 minutes. We were stuck in a congestion. It's kind of a bottleneck, and I'm glad we passed that. Didn't anything about 10 minutes were delayed our plans. But yeah, so far I'm riding for close to 3 hours now. The wind blast from the side is something that I don't like. I don't like it at all. The Meteor is super stable, but sometimes when you're getting hit from the sides, you don't feel good. Your head moves off, your helmet shakes. I hope you're enjoying the visuals. The visuals are nice. Smooth road, national highway, and my friend and the Thunderbolt 500 has gone way ahead, so I can't even see him. He is a seasoned rider, as I have said before, and he is pretty accustomed to overtaking. I am not very accustomed to overtaking on the highway unless there is a large gap. I would like to gradually overtake and not make cuts. I'm more of a defensive rider. I like to be a little on the safe side. The funny thing is, I'm going at 70. This is nothing. In the city, 70 feels like super fast. Over here, it really doesn't feel like anything. It feels slow on the highway. That's how it feels. Oh, beautiful road. So अगर आप मीटर खरीदने का सोच रहे हो, आप का अगर चॉइस क्रूजिंग होता है या हाईवे आप राइड करते हो या सिटी राइड के लिए भी, मीटर बहुत ही बढ़िया बाइक है. सो इट्स अ ग्रेट बाइक. इट्स नॉट ओनली फॉर हाईवे क्रूजिंग. इट्स अ वेरी निम्बल एंड हिटी बाइक. इट फील्स लाइट एंड इट्स ग्रेट फॉर सिटी कम्यूटिंग एज वेल. I am very comfortable riding this in the city. There is no fatigue. Even in highway, I didn't feel fatigue while coming back from the first 150 kilometers. In the last 50 kilometers or so, I was feeling fatigue because also the roads were narrower and I had to maneuver a lot. Coming back, I am not feeling very fatigue now, but yes, there is some residual fatigue from the first ride. But the meter is such a stable, smooth bike and the seating comfortability is top notch. I'm able to pull it without much trouble. But yes, my back is feeling a little fatigued, mostly due to I'm not used to such long rides. But yeah, that's the fun of it. I may, for the next time whenever I arrive, I may opt for an air cushion or low touring seat, which is even more comfortable that I've heard from people who have done the modification in their respective bikes. So this is a truck day, as you see. So I'm switching from Hindi to English, English to Hindi. I hope it's okay so that I can reach more and more people. And acha lagta hai Hindi mein bhi baat karna chahiye, though I am not a native Hindi speaker. I'm a Bengali from Calcutta, and Bangladesh block korbo. Bangladesh block korar ichcha ache. Kolahat ektu age ache, and ei to amar bondhura dani geche keno. Ki korche? Sanitize korche kono hat? Okay, guys. So we have entered Kolkata, and it's 2:16 PM. We started at around 10:15 PM, so roughly 4 hours of journey. We are just on the fringes of Kolkata, going to hit the Hooghly Bridge. That is the Hooghly Bridge, the second Hooghly Bridge. So we are on the Maha flyover now, pretty much in the heart of the city, and अभी हम लोग एक फ्रेंड को ड्रॉप करने जा रहे हैं, उसके बाद घर जाएंगे. एक ही बात बताना था कि ट्रिप बहुत बढ़िया था, मेरा पहला टोटल ऑफ वॉट किलोमीटर्स अराउंड सो फार अराउंड 360 kilometers ridden first time, and I'm going to end up with a sore lower back. Not sore, but it's kind of stiff right now. Sore butt for sure. but was it worth it? Absolutely it was. There are no two ways about it. I've never driven or ridden a bike for this long for such smooth highways before. Acha laga. 360 kilometers right now, and I reckon I end up with 375 to 380 kilometers after the detour till home. Alright then, I will end the vlog here. I'll see you soon. Thank you so much for staying with us. Thank you.